Casey from XPRO Elementor Addons. Today I'll be talking about how to use an animated link on your website. Animated link is a clickable element with fantastic animation effects. It redirects user to another web page, resource, document, or location within the same web page. They are typically displayed as a text. You will find them on almost any type of the website. E-commerce website uses animated link widget to highlight special offers or new products. Blogs uses this widget to add visual interest to their content. Not only this, but it can also be used in education website like this. First of all, make sure to download the free version of XPRO Elementor Addons by clicking on the link given in the description below. Or you can also watch our video on how to install and activate it. We have this incredible website for beauty treatment. Scrolling down, you will see their services page. This is the animated link. They have used it for their services like facial treatment, body treatment, nail care, and hydrotherapy. And when you click any of it, it will redirect you to the page where details are mentioned with the available timings and some other details. Now, let's remake it with me. Go to the widget panel and search animated link. Drag and drop it to your chosen page location. Here it is. This is the default view of the widget. Now, let's customize it. Come inside to the content tab into the general section. Here we have layouts, text, link, alignment, link ID, and on-click event options. Let's explore each one by one. First comes the layout option. The layout option comes up with a 25 unique animated style option that will make your link visually attractive for users. Let's try some. Style 1 is dropping animation underline to your text, while style 5 is creating another merging animation link. Style 10 is making the text of the link bold with animation. Style 20 is creating a liner box around the link. I'm setting link layout to style 10. Alright. Next we have the text option. With the text option, you can set the text of your widget. I'm setting it to facial treatment, okay? See, this will be our link now. Next, we have the link option. Here, you need to insert the reference link of the web page where you want to redirect the user. Copy its URL. Now, come back to your widget page. Here in the link option, paste the link that you have just copied. That's it. With the alignment option, you can set the widget to left, center, right, and justified. I'm setting it to left. Then comes the link ID option. Link ID is typically used when you want to direct user to the specific section on the same page. Simply go to that section, assign it a unique ID in the custom CSS ID option in the advanced tab, and paste that ID with hash in the link and link ID option. The on-click event option is used to execute some specific JavaScript functions when the link gets clicked. Simply write the function you want to perform. My developer fellows might know what I am talking about. For example, if you want to show an alert or want to download a file, simply put that function here. That's it. Now, let's style the widget. Inside the style tab, we have typography, text, shadow, and text color options. First comes the typography option. Click it and style the entire text. Select family as per your website. I am setting it to not a serif. Then we can change the text size either by using slider or by setting a value. I do the latter and setting the size to 22 pixel. With the weight option, you can select from drop-down menu thin, extra light, and other options to make your text visibility stylish. I'm using 400 normal. Then with the transform option, you can set the text to uppercase, lowercase, capitalize, and to default. I am setting it to default. With the style option, you can make your text normal, italic, and oblique. I am setting it to default. Then comes the decoration option. With it, you can underline the text, or you can add overline and line through to your text, but I'm not using it for my content. Then with the line height option, you can set the space between the lines of the text. I'm not using it. With the letter spacing option, we can set the space between letter of our text to make the text clean. I'm setting it to 1. Alright. Similarly, with the word spacing option, we can set the space between words of the text. I'm setting it to 1. Okay. Then with the text shadow option, we can insert shadow in the background of the text. Here we have the color option to set the shadow color. Then we have blur, horizontal and vertical options. However, I'm not using this option. In the normal section, we have text color option. I'm setting my text color to this, and using hover option, I'm changing the color to the same. Alright, that's it. Let's preview it. My link looks so fantastic, right? Thank you, XPRO Addons. Hope you learned something new today. If so, then hit the like button and subscribe to our channel for more Elementor videos like this. See you in the next video.